Drops, why is capillary condensation dependent on pore geometry and curvature? Capillary condensation is a process in which by multilayer adsorption of a vapour phase in a porous medium had turned into liquid phase. Gas particles flowing through a tube will be absorbed onto the tube wall and form multilayers. This is because the tube wall is so narrow that it gives molecule a much stronger intermolecular attraction. Gas molecule will combine to form small droplets through vent wall force. Small droplets will then join together to form larger droplets, eventually condensing at a lower pressure than the saturation pressure. Capillary tubes are put in the mouth of a hot kettle. Boiling water inside the kettle will cause the hot steam rising. As steam passes through the straw, it quickly condenses into water, even though the steam is still hot. This phenomenon is called capillary condensation. This phenomenon can be modeled using Kelvin equation. This is how Kelvin equation looks like. Notice that all the terms are kept constant except for equilibrium vapor pressure, PV, and mean curvature of meniscus H. Using cone as an example of pore, initially when pressure is zero, no condensation occurs. As you may observe, the radius of cone at the top is larger than that at the bottom, which means that equilibrium vapor pressure will be increased as height of liquid level increases. Using Kelvin equation with condition of PV smaller than P saturation, as PV increases, the value of ln PV over P saturation decreases, which in turn H decreases. H is equals to half of 1 over Rm plus 1 over Rc. This implies that the radius of meniscus increases and form flatter surface. As you may see in this diagram, a flatter surface has a larger radius of meniscus and a higher equilibrium vapor pressure. However, remember that the larger meniscus radius doesn't mean more vapor condensation. For the case of cylindrical pores, the radius of the tube is constant. The condensation process will occur much quickly in the constant radius pore. This is due to where radius is changed, condensation will stop as the liquid needs much more time to reach its new equilibrium vapor pressure. Since cylinder has constant radius, condensation occurs continuously as equilibrium pressure is constant. However, in real cases, the pore geometry are not always uniform. This is due to irregular shape or dust formation inside the pores. Curvature of meniscus will vary at each position of the tube. Thus, Kelvin equation has to be applied separately to study the behavior of meniscus. Now, how capillary condensation depends on the curvature of meniscus? Curvature of meniscus is actually based on the contact angle where the three interfaces meet. If the angle increases, the curvature of meniscus will decrease. According to the Kelvin equation, this will result in PV increasing, which means that lesser amount of vapor will be condensing. For the ease of calculation, we usually ignore the contact angle. In the aspect of chemical engineering, capillary condensation is used in the recovery of oil from tiny pores in the fractional distillation of crude oil. Besides that, it is also used in sintering of metal industry and ceramic industry.